Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And today we are going to discuss about the debilitation of Venus, which is happening in the sign of Virgo, which will happen for this month. And by the end of the month, Venus will feel as if it is entering Libra. And this is a very important transit of this year for the remaining months, because Venus gets debilitated just before it enters the Mool Trikon sign Libra. Okay, so what does Venus do when he enters Virgo, and why does he get debilitated there? All right. And as usual, whatever I say here will be applicable to your chart, depending on your individual chart, individual horoscope, not your sun sign, not your moon sign. And it will depend on where your Venus is and where the dispositor of Virgo, which is, I mean, the Lord of Virgo, which is Mercury, where Mercury is placed in your chart. And most importantly, which dashas you are running. Okay. All right. If you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this transit or any other area of your life, then please go down to the description section to book a reading with me. You will find the link to my website down. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So what's Virgo? So recently I made the video of Mercury transiting into Virgo. So in that I said that whenever Mercury enters Virgo, it's the best time to plan your life for the next year. And I said when Sun enters Aries, it's the best time to visualize your life, what you want from life. So Sun in Aries will tell you, or you should ask yourself, what you want from life. And then when Mercury enters Virgo, you should ask yourself, well, okay, I want it, but how do I get it? So Virgo represents, see, Virgo is the sign, is the original sixth house. Okay. So what is sixth house? Sixth house has many meanings. One of the houses, meanings of the sixth house is also sacrifice. So whenever a planet enters Virgo, you will always feel that there's a need for sacrificing something. Or if you have any planet in Virgo, then also the same thing can happen. You might want to sacrifice something. So the question is, what do we need to sacrifice there? Well, it is our desire of not letting things go the way it should go. So we have to sacrifice the desire of letting things go our way. That's what is Virgo. All right, because that's the opposite of Pisces. What is Pisces? Pisces says, let things go of its own accord. All right. Now, this does not mean you don't do anything, but it means that do your best and leave the rest to God and the universe. Whatever is there in your karma, that happens. So what is Venus basically? Venus represents our ability to love somebody, and loving anybody begins from loving ourselves. So therefore, many times it is said that many people like the idea of being in love. They don't like love actually. They like the idea of being in love with somebody. Yes. Many times you'll see people are asking, oh, when I will have a love affair, when I will have marriage, when I will have any loving interaction or anything. But what people don't realize is, along with love comes huge responsibility. There's a sense of commitment which is needed. But the question is, we have to ask ourselves, can we give that sense of commitment to somebody, or we just like the idea of being in love? See, love is separate from romance. Love and romance, in a way, has nothing to do with each other. Now, you could say that to be romantic, you need some love. Well, that's fine. That follows love, I would say. But it is not the same thing. What is romance? Romance is a trait of Libra, basically. Taurus and Libra. That's what Venus is. But love is a signification of the moon. All right. So moon and Venus are very different planets. And that is why they do not get well, they do not get along well with each other. Why does this happen? Because love is sattvic. It is pure. Love means I don't want anything from the person. There is nothing in me which the person can come and fulfill. But I want to make that person's life better. Why? For no reason. For no reason. There's no reason for love. Which means, irrespective of anything else, you just want to make the other person happy or happier. That's what is love. And that's what is the sign Cancer. The love of the mother, which is very selfless. Which means the mother is not thinking about herself before nourishing the child. But then what is Libra? Libra is give and take, is the sign of business. And that is why when somebody gets married, they say they have signed a contract. Yes, contract means I promise and you promise. So I will stay with you if you stay with me, and you will stay with me if I stay with you. So whenever the give and take business stops, the marriage breaks. This divorce or separation, or they leave each other, whatever it is. Okay. So that's Libra, and that's not love basically. So many times people think that getting married or getting into a relationship will make you happier. People think like that. Well, it can make you happier provided you are already happy. But if you are miserable inside, if you are not happy with your life, with your areas in life, then what happens is your misery spreads to your partner, and then your partner also becomes miserable. And that's what happens. You see, many times people, after getting married or after getting into a relationship, their happiness index goes down. They will call their friends and say that, I was so happy when I was single. Or I was so happier when I did not meet this person. Okay. So that's the biggest challenge for Venus in Virgo. Venus in Virgo asks this question that, do we have happiness in our life? Because a relationship is basically sharing your life. So when you have a bad life, bad does not mean difficult life. Okay, bad means you are basically not happy. You are not doing things which you should do, which you want to do, which you like to do. For some reason, the reason can be anything. But when you are unhappy inside, then you share your unhappiness with somebody. And when you are happy, you share your happiness with somebody. So if somebody thinks that just by activating Venus, you'll become happier, you are in an illusion. Because Venus does not rule happiness. Venus rules sharing. Right? So whatever is there in your life, that is exactly what you end up sharing with others. You cannot share love if you don't have love. Okay. And Virgo has these three nakshatras, as you know. Yes, the first nakshatra is Uttara Falguni. And then we have Hasta Nakshatra. And then we have Chitra Nakshatra. So Uttara Falguni is the place where we start making these contracts, deals, and negotiations. Uttara Falguni is the place where we start searching for somebody. Okay. I mean, that could be done in Purva Falguni also. Purva Falguni is more of that infatuation. And Uttara Falguni is more of finalizing the deal. Yes. So now you have signed the contract. But the question is, are you happy? If yes, then you have signed a great contract. If no, you have just, congratulations, you have just ruined the life of another person. And then comes Hasta Nakshatra. What is Hasta basically? Hasta is like the hands, as I said in that video. Yes. Hasta means working on something practically. So as they say, get some hands-on experience. Okay. And then what happens in Chitra? Chitra is polishing what you already made. Okay. So when Venus enters Uttara Falguni, and Venus is in Uttara Falguni now, it is a great time for us to check how much happy we are in our life. is my life good enough for another person to come and share with? Is my life good enough? What am I doing in my life? How are the pillars of my life? How is my health? How is my inner happiness? How is my career going on? Career doesn't mean some superficial company or something like that, or some business. Career means, in general, what are you doing in life? Are you simply wasting time? There are many people who are having big, big careers, I know, but they are simply wasting time. And there are many people I know who don't have careers, but still they are doing wonderful. They are very happy in life. So just because you have a big job in an MNC, or maybe you have a million followers, it doesn't mean you are having a career, all right? Career means you are doing what you want to do and what you are doing. That is matching. Then that is called happiness, okay? Now, if you are just giving excuses that, oh, I can't do this because of that, and then that means you are not having a career, basically. Because 10th house is the house of your karma and 6th house is job. In a way, both are linked because both gives you money, but both are totally different. Okay. 6th house just makes you work. 6th house is like cutting your hair, cutting your nails, or taking bath. It's like the daily activities. And job also, if it is a matter of 6th house, it gives you no happiness, no satisfaction. You are just doing something just because it pays you some money, maybe. So instead of doing what you love, which is the 10th house, maybe you are just working under somebody and that's all is happening and your life is becoming more and more miserable. Okay. And when you do that introspection in Uttar Falguni, then you enter Hasta Nakshatra. So in Hasta, you understand what are the flaws. And that is why you are working on it. So any planet which is in Hasta can give you a sense of knowledge about the flaws that you have regarding that planet. Okay. And then what happens in Chitra? In Chitra, you are trying to polish it. And in the Virgo part of Chitra, okay, in the that part, then you are continuing to furnish it. That's why it's the shining jewel. So it's shining, you see. But nothing shines unless you work on it. And then when it enters Libra, the Chitra Padas of Libra, that is the time when everybody comes and says, oh, I want to be a part of your life. So therefore, now when Venus is crossing the zone, it is a very good time to sit and introspect before it enters Libra, before you show to the entire universe who you are, what your life is. And show doesn't mean you are just showing your body or face or your skin or anything like that, or exposing yourself. It doesn't mean that. It means any acknowledgement from other people. Oh, okay, this is good in your life. Oh, that is good. This is nice. This is good. This is bad. This is not working. That's not nice. So before we reach there, now is the place where we try to cultivate ourselves from inside and lead a happier life. Because if we are happy, then our spouse is happy. And that is why they say your vibe attracts your tribe. If you are unhappy, you will attract an unhappy spouse. Why is that? Now, nobody wants to attract an unhappy spouse, but you will end up attracting who is also unhappy. Why? Because suppose you are not happy in your life and you are trying to fulfill the sense of emptiness through somebody else, okay, then what will happen is you will compromise on so many things. And then you will also attract somebody who is also compromising. Okay, and when I say compromise, I don't mean compromise at a physical level. That, okay, I look like a Miss Universe, so I am compromising on a man's appearance. I'm not talking about that. What I'm saying is, at an inner level, who you are, that frequency will compromise because you will be desperate. And you can see these people all around the place. Yes, many times I see it in office. They have come to the office, but they are flirting with members of the opposite sex. What is going on? Why that is going on? Because they're not having any fulfillment in their life. So they are trying to fill that void, you see, with the opposite sex. That's what is going on. Yes. And then what happens? The other person also wants to fill that void. So you give them a lot of opportunities to come to you. And then that person also gives you a lot of opportunities to come to them. And that is how you come together and maybe enter a relationship or get married. And then both are miserable. You end up making each other more miserable. That's what happens, you see. And the moment you see that your life has improved, all your life areas have become balanced, all the other areas, then you will attract a very healthy person, a healthy partner, or the existing relationship with your partner will improve multifold times. So many times people ask me how to improve relationships or married life. The answer is very simple. You can't improve the other person, but you can improve yourself. So improve yourself and do your best and leave the rest to God and the universe. All right. So take a note of the things which you should work on during this transit. And then work on it in Hasta and polish it when it enters Chitra. Okay. And when I say these nakshatras, you don't have to go to a fake, unnecessary, useless obsession on dates. Okay. Oh, when is Venus entering Chitra? When is he entering this? When is he entering that? Forget about dates. Those are all useless, rubbish information. Oh, Venus is entering Chitra after 1 week, 10 days. That will automatically happen. Okay. Don't be so date-centric that you forget the essence only. Because now, suppose I tell you, of course, you can go and check it in Drik Pancha. But if you become too much obsessed, that, oh, okay, Chitra is, you know, now, I should polish it now, and, you know, Asta is now, I should do this now. So then you will miss the point. It's like a person who has a beautiful plate of maybe some very good food, but he is busy recording that. He can't enjoy the present, you see. So let the transits flow. Don't get obsessed with when this will happen, that will happen. It will happen automatically. But don't miss the opportunity, because Venus will again enter Virgo after another year. Okay. So utilize this opportunity to improve your life and become a better person, better human being. And then you will see automatically all the other aspects of your life, including your relationships, they will improve. And by that, you will have happier relationships. Okay. Thank you very much for your patience. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who wants to know about Venus transit into Virgo. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this transit, then you can always go down to the description section of my videos to book a reading with me. Okay. Thank you so much.